So let's welcome on board Vishwavir Ahuja, the MD and CEO at RBL Bank. Mr. Ahuja, thanks so much for joining in. We've seen a strong profit growth led by NII and non-interest income as well. However, provisions have increased. What have been the key performance drivers for you?
So first of all, I think the line in terms of our performance continues as per our expectations and as the guidance that we've been giving, that there is strong underlying growth of all our businesses, and we've been able to sustain that. So both NII and non-interest income have grown handsomely. But you know, even within non-interest income, across the board, across net profit has also grown again in line with our expectations. We've had 36% year-on-year growth in terms of net profit. The NIM trajectory has improved further, and you know, it has been improving for several quarters and now has touched a peak of 4.12%. We are very happy with that, and we are in fact confident the way things are going, we'll be able to maintain that level going forward. And in a way, if you break it down, you know, even the other components in terms of asset growth, in terms of asset quality, everything is stable. There is an increase in provisions, but that is the credit costs associated with that are well in line with our, you know, plan and expectations. And we've been able to absorb that quite comfortably. So that's where we are at. So, you know, GNPA is down, net NPA is down, PCR is up, return on equity is up, ROA is up. So I think you should take that into that context.
Mr. Ahuja, afternoon. Now your margins have improved on a year-on-year basis. How has the sequential performance been? And can you tell us what levels you see margins, you know, stabilizing at, given the fact that there is a rising cost of funds currently?
Two parts. One is the effect of the increase in cost of funds. I think you would have also noticed that to a very large extent, the increase in cost of funds, we have been able to pass it on through MCLR increases, etc. So in many ways, that sort of balances each other out. And on a net basis, the mix of businesses between wholesale and non-wholesale, you know, is also gradually moving more towards the retail side. And the retail contribution, in, you know, is increasing because that those businesses are growing faster. And that is also helping in terms of the improvement in the net interest margins. So while the cost effects are being countered and passed on, there is also a net increase that is happening because of the change in the business mix or the portfolio mix. And that is what gives us confidence that even if there is a little more increase in cost of funds going forward, again, you know, through the lag effect of some of the MCLR decisions that we've already made, as also because of the continued change in the business mix.
Right. You know, we've seen slippages which have risen to about 211 crore rupees on a sequential basis. Which segments are you seeing the stress coming in from?
Basically, the slippage is coming from the partly from the agri portfolio of the bank. Yeah. On the micro banking side, in fact, they have actually come down. And we have been saying for the last 3-4 quarters that the post-demonetization portfolio, which had to be provided for, we have been providing for in the last 1 year, and those provisions are pretty much done with this quarter, you know.
All right, and we've also seen strong advances growth at 35%. Your deposit growth has been healthy. At what levels do you see this stabilizing? And do you have enough capital to grow, given the capital consumption has been higher?
Yeah, so we've been maintaining the fact that both advances and deposit growth will be in the 30 to 35% range. And, you know, it is satisfying that we've been able to perform at the upper end of that, you know, in the past. But we continue to maintain that as the range for future growth also. So, you know, not changing that in any way. And as far as the capital consumption is concerned, I think there may be some higher or relatively lower capital consumption in terms of, you know, how they stack up from a risk weight point of view and otherwise. But effectively, what it comes down to, we consume between 35 and 40 basis points of capital every quarter.
Right. So, you know, you did mention about the Vision 2020, wherein advances growth was expected at about 30 to 35 odd percent, ROA at 1.5%, and cost income ratio at about almost 0.7 to about 1%. Are you on track to achieve those numbers for 2020?
So the Vision 2020 was put in place pre-IPO, you know, in mid-2016. We are now, you know, in 2019. On advances, we had said 30-35% CAGR. We are doing better than that. On CASA, we had given a certain indication. We are doing better than that. On other income being at least one-third of total income, we've been doing better than that. On operating efficiency, i.e. cost income ratio of 51-52%, we are already at that, and although we said we'll reach that by 2020, I think we have already kind of reaching that now. And in terms of the return ratios, ROE and ROA, we had indicated that we will be exiting March 19 with a ROE of just under 13.5%. I think we are more or less good with that. And ROA also, we had said that we will improve by about 10 basis points, you know, every year. So far we've been good with that. Yes, there has been some slowdown, you know, largely coming in the corporate sector with so many developments that we are all aware of. We don't need to list them out. And that does create a little more caution, you know, if I may put it that way.
Thanks very much, Mr. Ahuja, for taking time out and giving us a snapshot as to how things have shaped up for the company as well as for the quarter gone by. Let's just quickly address the flashes on your screens, and this is with respect to Dr. Reddy's. The US FDA has issued an observation. This is for the...